Hello, my name is Rachel Huddett and I'm a scientific curator at PharmGKB. In this video, we're going to look at how PharmGKB assigns a level of evidence to its clinical annotation. Before we begin, a quick note to say that this video will assume some basic familiarity with PharmGKB variant annotations and clinical annotations. If you're new to these types of annotation, there's a link to an introductory video in the description below. We'll begin with a quick refresher on how variant annotations and clinical annotations are linked. A variant annotation is a single sentence which records a single finding from a single paper, while clinical annotations bring together variant annotations and other pieces of curated evidence to summarise what's known about a particular variant drug phenotype relationship. We assign a level of evidence to all clinical annotations to indicate the strength of the underlying evidence base. Our levels of evidence run from level 4 for associations which aren't supported by the curated evidence to level 1, which is assigned to associations with the strongest evidence, including support from drug labels and clinical guidelines. We use an algorithm to assign a level of evidence to clinical annotations. This flowchart gives you an overview of the different steps of the algorithm. Each individual variant annotation included in the clinical annotation is scored in a 5-step process. The next few slides will go over each step. Each step of the process scores a particular attribute of the variant annotation. These scores are combined as shown on the slide to produce a total score for the variant annotation. It is important to understand that the score given to a variant annotation is not an indication of the quality of the study. The scoring system was designed by PharmGKB as a way to quickly compare variant annotations against each other as part of assigning a level of evidence to clinical annotations. The first step of variant annotation scoring looks at the phenotype category assigned to the annotation. Phenotype categories covering clinical outcomes such as dosage, efficacy, and toxicity are given higher scores in this step as they are more clinically relevant. Step 2 assesses any reported p-values included in the study parameters of the variant annotation. Lower, more significant p-values score more in this step. For variant annotations with multiple p-values, the lowest p-value is used for scoring in this step, and the set of study parameters containing that p-value are used for scoring in subsequent steps. Variant annotations from GWAS studies are checked for both a discovery and replication cohort and scored for successful replication of the reported association. The cohort size of the study is scored in step 3. We use the cohort size from the same set of study parameters as the p-value used for step 2. Larger cohort sizes are given a higher score. Step 4 assesses any effect sizes reported by the study. If the study parameters report an odds ratio, hazard ratio, or relative risk of 2 or more, or 0.5 or less, and the confidence interval does not cross 1, and there's an associated p-value of 0.05 or lower, then points are awarded. Step 5 acts as a multiplier in the algorithm and is split into two parts. Step 5A gives a reduced score for meta-analysis studies and in vitro studies. Scores from meta-analyses are reduced to avoid potential double scoring of the original datasets, which may have been already annotated into PharmGKB. In vitro studies, for example those carried out in cell lines or tissue samples, are given a reduced score as their findings may not necessarily be directly translatable to what happens in patients. Studies which only provide associations in the context of phenotype groups instead of specific alleles or diplotypes are also given a reduced score in step 5A. While these annotations can give us an indication of the general direction of a pharmacogenetic association, they don't have the specificity we need to base a clinical annotation on them. Step 5B looks at the association and significance reported in the annotation. Variant annotations which report a significant association between a variant and drug are given a positive score, while annotations which report no association between a variant and drug are given a negative score. variant annotations which report an association which is either not significant or the paper doesn't say anything about the significance of the association are given a score of 0. An exception is made for studies with cohorts with less than 50 participants. Many studies on rare alleles are in small cohorts, and it's difficult to find a statistically significant association in these cohorts. However, this doesn't mean that there isn't a valid pharmacogenetic association between the variant and drug being studied. No matter what they score, all relevant variant annotations are added to a clinical annotation. Coming back to the flow diagram, you'll see that once all the variant annotations are scored, we look for clinical guidelines or FDA drug labels which give variant-specific prescribing guidance for the variant drug or gene drug pair covered by the annotation. Currently, we add relevant guidelines from CPIC and the DPWG or drug labels from the US FDA to our clinical annotations. These are the three sources that we're able to regularly curate and update, but we can add other sources in the future if we're able to easily maintain and update annotations on them. The scores of the variant annotations and any clinical guidelines or FDA drug labels are then combined to give a total score for the clinical annotation. At this point, PharmGKB scientific curators can adjust the score by tagging any conflicting variant annotations. Conflicting variant annotations are those which report an association in the opposite direction to the majority of evidence included in the clinical annotation. For example, the variant annotation shown here reports that the AA genotype is associated with a decreased risk of developing opioid dependence compared to the AG or GG genotypes. However, the majority of variant annotations attached to the same clinical annotation report that the AA genotype is associated with an increased risk of opioid dependence. Variant annotations which have been tagged as conflicting display this conflicting evidence tag on the clinical annotation page. The score of a clinical annotation is used to automatically set a level of evidence for the annotation, as shown in this table. The algorithm uses a separate scoring range for rare variants, broadly defined as those found at a global population frequency of less than 1%. Rare variants are not commonly reported on and tend to only be found in small studies. Use of this scoring range compensates for this. The total score alongside a breakdown and any level modifiers are displayed on each clinical annotation page at the top of the evidence section. If you have any questions about the material covered in this video, please contact us at feedback@pharmgkb.org. Thank you.